To-do, ToDoIst, or to-anydo. I really gotta stop doing those intros. ToDoIst and Anydo are two different productivity apps that people seem to enjoy me reviewing, so I'm just gonna review it again. I don't know why I wouldn't do that. But I'm gonna do it against each other. So first and foremost, I am a fan of ToDoIst. I've used the app many times. I have a Skillshare course on it. I am a fan of Anydo. But the difference between these applications is decently stark in a few areas. First of all, from a pricing perspective, there is a premium version for Anydo that is $2.99 a month if you go for the annual, and there's a couple different pricing models, but it's only premium or free. And then ToDoIst, from a pricing perspective, has free, pro, and business. A pro version is pretty much all you need. I mean, if you're on a team, yes, you can use obviously the business option, but I'm not the biggest fan that like ToDoIst business costs more than Notion Pro, if you get what I'm saying. I mean, it's cheaper than Notion business, but still, it's like, really? Is that what we're doing here? Regardless, I can appreciate the fact that it's an exceptional application. So when you go to Anydo and you log in here, I do like the fact that it's got a Google Calendar integration that's pretty native. And this only really brings in the one calendar that you have. You can't bring in like multiple calendars. It's just your main one. But still, I like it. And for me, I enjoy working in an application that shows you a calendar like that, whereas ToDoIst does not. If I go here, you'll see that this is fine. I mean, it has a nice Google Calendar integration in the sense that it can pull up your tasks in this calendar on Google, which I've made a video on numerous times. But for example, here's a joke task I have over here called Make Me Happy on September 13th. And it can bring things like that in, where essentially it'll just like take that into your Google Calendar and actually show time blocks based on when you put it. You can set the defaults to different time frames, but it is not gonna do anything like showing it while you're on your checklist, which is more of a daily planner style of things. When it comes to the tagging and all that kind of stuff, I'm a little bit disappointed in the fact that priority is limited by priority or not on the free plan. And that's the only tag you can get on the free plan with Anydo. When you take a look at this, you don't really have recurring tasks here. You can change it between different lists, which is something you can obviously do on ToDoIst, but ToDoIst allows you to do recurring tasks, subtasks, and while you can add subtasks, for example, with do laundry, clean room, clean bathroom, and you can add notes in attachments, you can't make a subtask of a subtask. Like, I like that you can drag it up and down, but you can't even drag this out. You can quickly switch between lists, which is cool, but yeah, it's just not like, there's not that natural language processing feel to it as well. I mean, yes, you can quickly add a task down here. Cool, like take out the trash. But something that's amazing about ToDoIst is that I can press Alt key right now and I can do take out the trash and then put it into my personal project. Or I can put it in like a growth project, whatever it is. Like I can quickly do this kind of stuff. It's like not important, or it's like important, but not urgent. And then I can go quickly. And if you wanted to set up an Eisenhower matrix like I had before, it's like, it's important and not urgent. So that's the quadrant it's in. And that kind of quick stuff is just not something that Anydo is really for. The mobile app looks pretty good. This is very simple. And you can even have, it's nice that you can even see your tasks next to your calendar stuff and you can check off stuff on there. But even for this, it's like, I've had this checked off in here for a while. So I gotta like delete it now for it to go away. I don't really like that. I don't really get the point of having to delete it. So it has no history whatsoever, pretty much is what I'm being told. And the sorting options you have are like you can sort it by list or time. That's it. When it comes to ToDoIst, if you're in a project view, you can sort it and group it by a multitude of things, which is much more appreciated. I've done a whole GTD setup in here and I actually enjoyed it. Whereas with this, it's very basic. It's very basic, just like write it down. It gives you the analog option for sure. I personally wouldn't do Anydo before I would use ToDoIst, but it's like to each is their own, right? If you want to try out something that's pretty basic, maybe go for Anydo, but I personally am a fan of ToDoIst. I check out my Skillshare course on ToDoIst in the link down below. It's definitely helped a lot of people learn the application, and this video can help you learn a lot about how you can improve your productivity even more.